Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel, my D1D2 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to chapter 10, which is Pythagoras theorem. Your book is D2 Math and SM2, and I'm going to explain you question number 3 of exercise 10A. Students, question number 3 is: in triangle ABC, AB is equal to 8 cm, BC is equal to 15 cm, right angle B and the angle B is equal to 90 degree. Find the length of AC. So first we will draw this right angle triangle. Okay, so this is your right angle triangle as given in the question. Students, remember that they are saying you that angle B is equal to 90 degree and it's at B. So it means that this straight line, the line which goes straight up, is your 90 degree angle. So it means that this is angle is equal to 90 degree. So it means that this is B, because they have told you that angle B is equal to 90 degree, and you have to draw the triangle, right angle triangle ABC. So it means that this is A and this is C. So your AB is 8 cm, BC is 15 cm. They are asking you to find out the length of AC. So we have to find out this length. So here we are going to use the formula of the we are going to use Pythagoras theorem, which is hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. So students, remember that in right angle triangle, this is always your hypotenuse and this is your base and this is your perpendicular. So here, okay ji, so here I'm going to put the values. Your hypotenuse, you have to find out hypotenuse, and hypotenuse is AC. So we are going to take the square of AC, and perpendicular is given to you. This is your perpendicular, which the line which goes straight up is your perpendicular, which is 15 centimeter. We'll take the square of 15, and base square means that you will take the square of 8. Base is 8. Now take the square. AC square is equal to 15 square. Now you'll take the square of 15, so you will get 15 square will be equal to 225. So it means that 15 square is 225. And now I'm going to take the square of 8. 8 is 64. So this is your 64. Now you will add 64 in 225. So what you will get? You will get 289. So students, as you just need to find out the value of AC, you don't need this square. So to omit the square, you have to take square root on both sides. And this is the rule of the equation. If you're taking square root on one side, so you have to take the square root on the other side. So here you have to take the square root on both sides. This square and square root will cut each other. So when you will take the square of 289, what you will get? You will get 17. So your answer is 17 centimeter. Okay, I hope that it's clear to you. Now let's move forward to question number 4. Okay, so question number 4 is a triangle DEF, and this triangle DEF is a right angle triangle at E. Now you have to make right angle at, you have to make 90 degree angle at E. Okay, with DE is equal to 6.7 meter and EF is equal to 5.5 meter, find the length of DE. Okay, so now this is the right angle triangle. As it has been told in the question, that right angle triangle is at 90 degree. Right angle triangle means 90 degree angle. So it means that 90 degree angle is at E. So it means that this is your D and this is your F, D, E, F. Now the length is given to you. DE is equal to 6.7 meter and EF is equal to 5.5 meter. You have to find out this hypotenuse, which is DF. Okay, so again, you will use the formula of the right angle triangle. You will use a Pythagoras theorem, and which is hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. So hypotenuse you have to find out, which is DF. So you'll take the square of it. Base is 6.7. So you take the square of 6.7, and perpendicular is 5.5. So you will take the square of 5.5. So DF square you write down as it is. Now you'll take the square of 6.7. So what you will get? 6.7 square is equal to 44.89. So 44.89, you will write down 44.89. Now you will take the square of 5.5, but you will get 5.5 square is equal to 30.25. So 5.5 square is 30.25. You write down 30.25. Now you will add both numbers. So what you will get when you will add 30.25 and 44.89? You will get 75.14. Students, as I have told you that we just need DF, so we don't need this square. So to cut the square, you have to take the square root on both sides. This is the rule that if you're taking the square root on one side, you have to take the square root on the other side. So this square and square root will cut each other. So DF will be equal to 8.6, or if you want to round off, you can round off 8.7. So 8.7 meter is your answer. Okay, ji. I hope that question number 4 is also clear to you. Now let's move forward to question number 5. Okay, so question number 5 is in a triangle GHI, GH is equal to 33 centimeter, GI is equal to 65 centimeter, and angle H is equal to 90 degree. Find the length of HI. Okay, so now this is your question number 5. They have told you that angle 90 H is equal to 90 degree angle. So now this is your 90 degree angle and this is G. So it means that this is G and this is I. Alright, so the measurement is given to you. GH is 33 centimeter, GI is 65 centimeter. You have to find out perpendicular, which is IH. I'm again telling you that in writing a triangle, this is your perpendicular, this is your hypotenuse, and this is your base. So you have to find out perpendicular. So first write down the formula of the Pythagoras theorem, which is hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. As we have to find out perpendicular now, so I'll move this base to this side. So it will become hypotenuse square minus base square is equal to perpendicular square. So it means that perpendicular square is equal to hypotenuse square minus base square. So hypotenuse is, this is your hypotenuse, so 65. So you will take the square of 65. Now minus base square. So base is your 33. You will take the square of 33. Now come to this side. Alright, so perpendicular square is equal to, now you will take the square of 65, but you will get so 65 square is equal to 4225 plus, and now you will take the square of 33, so it will come 1089. Now you have to add these both numbers. So 1089 plus 4225 will be equal to 5314. So as we know that we just need to find out perpendicular. So your perpendicular is in this figure your perpendicular is HI. So you'll take the square of HI. Now 5314. To omit this square, you have to take the square root on both sides. Square and square root will cut each other. So the value of HI is square root 5314 will be equal to 72.8. So you can round off this number as 72.9 meters. So HI is equal to 72.9. I hope that it's clear to you. Now let's move forward to question number 6. Okay, so question number 6 is a triangle MNO is right angled at 10. So at 10, you have to draw the 90 degree angle with NO is equal to 11 meter and MO is equal to 14.2 meter. Find the length of MN. So students, as it is told you that at n it's your right angle triangle, so it means that this is 90 degree angle and I have made a degree angle at n. So this is MNO, it's a right angle triangle. MO is given to you, which is 14.2, and NO is given to you, which is 11 meters. So you have to find out base, which is MN. So first write down the formula of the Pythagoras theorem is hypotenuse square perpendicular square plus base square. As we have to find out base, so we will move this perpendicular to this side. So it's adding over here, it will come to this side, it will be subtracted from hypotenuse. So base square is equal to hypotenuse square minus perpendicular square. So your base is MN, so write down MN square. Your hypotenuse is given to you, which is your hypotenuse, which is 14.2. So you will take the square of 14.2. And perpendicular is given to you, which is 11. So you will take the square of 11. Now MN whole square is equal to, take the square of 14.2, so what you will get, 14.2 square is equal to 201.64 minus, when you will take the square of 11, so you will get 121. Now MN whole square is equal to, now you have to subtract 121 from 201. And 201.64 minus 121 will be equal to 80.64. So as you know that you have to find out the value of MN, so you don't need this square. So to omit the square, you have to take the square root on both sides. So this square and square root will cut each other. So the value of MN is equal to, okay, so square, when you will take the square root of this answer, you will get 8.9. So you write down 8.9 meters. So this is your answer. Okay, so I hope that today's lecture is clear to you. Do the practice of the sum, because when you do the practice, then this concept will be more clear to you. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.